Hello students, coming to the next topic, that is texture and structure and form of igneous rocks. Let us see what do you mean by texture and what do you mean by structure and how igneous rocks are verified or differentiated with respect to texture and structure. What is the main principle behind the igneous rock textures? So, it is believed that the fundamental principle behind the igneous rock texture is nothing but the grain size, which is controlled by the rate of cooling, Also, thus, the rapid cooling at the Earth's surface of extrusive molten material or the lava, which will result in the growth of smaller crystals. Or it may prevent the crystal growth altogether. So rapid cooling is very dangerous because it also results in the growth of smaller crystals, or sometimes it prevents the crystal growth altogether. Conversely, slow cooling within the Earth's crust in intrusive molten material, that is nothing but the magma, which will result in the growth of fewer but larger crystals. Because atoms are able to migrate through the liquid to attach the igneous rock textures to begin the formation of the crystal. Hence, it is very advantageous that slow cooling has to be done. Okay, so the many igneous rock textures are simply variations on or modifications of this principle. Understood, rapid cooling is not preferred, that to add the lava or extrusive molten material. The slow cooling, that is at the magma where the formation of the fewer crystals is preferred. Let me summarize. That is, slow cooling within the Earth's crust of intrusive molten material called magma is preferred. Okay, slow cooling within the Earth's crust. Of intrusive molten material which is called magma which results in the growth of fewer but larger crystals. So larger crystals is preferred. Okay. So this is the main principle behind the modification of the igneous rock textures. Okay. Coming to igneous textures, let us see what are the different type of textures we have. Individual grains which are related to other grains which are immediately next to them. This will define the texture. Mainly the grains which is next to grains, how they are attached to each other and how they are position will determine the texture. So here these are nothing but these textures are useful indicators of cooling and also the crystallization rates, and also they are the main relation between the minerals and the magma at the time of the crystallization. Okay. Also, textures deal with small scale features which are seen in very hand specimen or under the microscope, such as the degree of crystallinity, grain size, grain shape, grain orientation, grain boundary relations, crystal intergroup, etc. Let me revise what are the different handy indications due to the textures. We have the degree of crystallinity, the degree of crystallinity, grain size. Grain shape. Grain orientation. Grain boundary relations. Crystal intergrowths. These are the different handy indicators which we'll use to identify the igneous textures. Let us study about each and every aspect and let us know how to identify the igneous texture. Coming to degree of crystallinity, here we have a holocrystalline, holohyaline, and hypocrystalline. What do you mean by holocrystalline? If a material is said to be holocrystalline, it is nothing but it is only consisting entirely of the crystal, entire whole crystal. Okay, this is a point you have to remember. What is holohyaline? It is nothing but a material which is consisting both crystal and glass. Okay, crystal plus glass. What do you mean hypocrystalline? Hypocrystalline is nothing but entirely of the glass. The material will consist entirely, nothing but whole glass. Okay. Coming to grain size. What do you mean by grain size? It is nothing but characterized by the large size minerals which can easily be seen with our naked eyes. Nothing but 2 mm or greater. These are the grain size. 2 mm or greater. Greater or equal to 2 mm. They are differentiated broadly three types. That is coarse grained phanaric, medium grained phanaric, fine grained phanaric. Depending upon the size of the grains, which are greater than 5 mm are coarse grain, which are between 1 mm to 5 mm are medium grain, and which are less than 1 mm are differentiated as fine grained phanarics. Coming to the next criteria, that is the grain shape. What do you mean by grain shape? Anhedral allotriomorphic is the first one, where the all component mineral grains are anhedral. What do you mean by anhedral? They are having no corners or no specific shapes. Okay, that is known as anhedral, which are having soft surfaces. We can tell that the crystals which are having the soft surfaces. This is the first one, differentiated. What is second one? Subhedral hypidiomorphic. What is subhedral hypidiomorphic? Nothing but few surfaces will be soft and few surfaces will be exactly the sharp, like corners. These are some material species are anhedral, those of other are subhedral, where so many even surfaces are formed. For example, the granite rock, quartz and orthoclase. These are all like combination of both anhedral. And the other one is euhedral. What is euhedral? They have a perfect surfaces. It's not like soft surfaces. They have perfect surfaces. It is nothing but euhedral. The crystal will have perfect surfaces. Here what happens is every grain material is euhedral in nature. Coming to the grain orientation. What do you mean by grain orientation? It is nothing but the tachyotic texture, where a texture wherein the grains which will show preferred orientation due to the flowage and the interstices between the grains which are occupied by glass or crystals. This is nothing but the orientation due to flowage. What is the grain orientation? It is nothing but the orientation due to flowage and the interstices between the grains. Okay, it is mainly due to the intersections or interstices between the grains which are occupied by glass or crystalline material. Coming to the next thing, that is graphic texture. What is a graphic texture? It is nothing but debritified minerals which are forming angular wedges, which are angular wedges like shapes, which will look like reminiscent of the writing. How we are writing, like just like the writing on it. Okay, here we can see there are some writings, like they are not actually writings, it looks like that. And it is nothing but the graphic texture where the feldspar is white and roughly 10 into 10 cm, quartz are the little gray ones. Here you have two materials. The white one is feldspar. The white is feldspar. And what is a gray one? Gray one is nothing but the quartz. Coming to the grain boundary relations, it is one of the other type. Here, it refers to a situation where there is a continuous range in grain size for one or more species. Here, what happens is, from the crystalline, they progress to smaller sizes, which are increasingly numerous. This texture is commonly shown by plagioclase in some of the audiocyte cases. Okay, this is nothing but the continuity, how the boundary relations with other material. It is a continuous range, okay, in the grain size of one or more mineral species. Coming to igneous structure, what is the igneous structure? Let us see. The structure of the igneous rocks are large scale features which are very much seen with our naked eyes and dependent on very many factors like composition of magma, viscosity of magma, temperature and pressure at which it is cooling and consolidation takes place, pressure of the gases or the presence of the gases and other volatiles. Let me repeat. Composition of magma, viscosity of magma, like what is the flow property, how freely it can viscous, like flow, resistance towards the flowing, viscosity of magma, and temperature and pressure at which the cooling takes place. Temperature and pressure at which cooling simultaneously consolidation takes place, and the presence of gases, presence of gases and other volatiles. These are the main several factors on which the igneous structures are dependent. So also the structures which are developed in igneous rocks are basically of two types. What are those? The first one is intrusive, which formed by the crystallization of magma. The first one is intrusive, which is mainly formed by the crystallization of magma. Within the earth, which with the depth, at a depth within the earth, okay, at a depth within the earth. So the point we have to remember is this: intrusive rocks are characterized by large crystal size. That is, visual appearance will show individual crystals which are interlocked with one another. Okay, so this is the main criteria where the intrusive rocks can also be seen with the naked eyes with large crystals. Okay, the cooling of magma deep in the earth is typically more slower than the cooling process at the surface. So larger crystals can grow at this intrusive. Larger crystals can grow. What is the next variety? That is nothing but extrusive. What is extrusive? Extrusive nothing but, which is a form. The second variety is extrusive, which will form formed by the crystallization mainly of magma at the surface of the earth. The name itself is extrusive, means exterior. This is intrusive, within a depth within the earth. This is the main difference. Here what happens is, these are characterized by fine grain textures because a rapid cooling will take place at or near the surface. It will not provide enough time for the larger crystals to grow. There will be no growth of the crystals. Small size crystals will be taking place. Okay, the other one is rocks with the fine grain textures are called the aphanitic rocks. And also the most common extrusive rock is basalt. Basalt is the best example of the extrusive rock because it is formed at the surface of the earth. What are the forms of igneous rocks? Actually, let us see briefly what are the forms. Again, we have we will discuss also about the forms of igneous rocks further. Igneous rock, which is formed from cooling and also the crystallization of magma, as we studied in the earlier slide, will generally acquire by cooling, by the variety of shapes, which will depend on number of factors like the structural decomposition of host rock, that is nothing but the country rock, and viscosity of magma or lava, composition of magma and lava, and the environment where it takes place. There are four factors. The main things are the structural decomposition or disposition of the host rock, structural disposition of host rock. What is host rock? Is nothing but the country rock, the origin rock. And viscosity of magma or lava. Viscosity of magma or lava. And composition of magma or lava. Like what percentage they are present. And the environment at which they are taking place. The environment in which or at which injection of magma is taking place. These are the different things. Again, coming to the forms, like what are the different forms? They are subdivided. They are mainly divided into two broad cases. One is concordant and discordant. This is the first variety. What is concordant bodies? Nothing but they are intrusion in which magma is injected and cooled along the structural planes of the country rock. This will be along the structural plane. What is discordant? Nothing but these intrusive bodies which have been injected without the influence of the structural decomposition. And they are oblique or transverse to the bedding planes. They are transverse to the bedding planes. These are transverse. And the concordant are along the structural plane. Along. This is the main difference. Thank you.